Hey guys, it's Alexsia from Dimitri Alexsia, and this will be Alexa, stop. And this is my first hair tutorial, and this should be the final result, which is what I had in Rugged Swing Festival for the showcase we performed. And sometimes it's always the same, sometimes it's different because I'm not professional, and I'm starting to do these tutorials for people like me that really don't know how to use the hair and the hands. And it's actually very easy, like we just try to make it work somehow, but it works, sometimes it works. So I found some easy ways to have some, you know, fancy and a bit unusual hair. And a lot of you asked me, a lot of our students and people we meet around, they asked us, so we will just give it a try and let's see if it's helpful. Let's start. First of all, we start by brushing our hair to make sure there are no tangles and it's easy to work with it. Then I take a front part of my hair, which is not so small, it's actually pretty big. So just because it's easier for me to work with it after, and we put it on the side, I secure it there, so the other part of my hair is not bothered by it. At this point, we split our hair in two parts, equal parts. I'm taking one side and do a small ponytail just to put it on the side, leave it on the side. Then with the other hair, I make a ponytail quite high on my head, and I secure it with a rubber band. Now once we have it, I take the other section of hair and I do the same. I create another ponytail, but it doesn't have to be in the same position of the first one. Actually, I want this ponytail to be closer to the first one. So eventually we will have one ponytail on the side and one more in the center. So now I take the first ponytail, I split the hair in two, and I start twisting the two sections of hair. Once I twisted them, I also twist them together. I make sure it's a bit tight so it looks better after. So I secure it with a rubber band and then plop, there's a fake braid. Now it's time to shape it, so I just put it in my head, on my head, and try to see if I like it, if I don't like it. And I will secure the very end of the braid with a pin. And after, I can add a few larger pins, just to make sure it stays and it doesn't go away. In this case, I put two. Well, two should be enough. If you don't feel safe, you can add more, but little by little you will understand how to put them and how to fix them and how to make sure they really take the hair and make it stay together. So two should be enough. Then I take the second section of hair and I braid it like normal braid. So I take three parts and I braid them. This braid doesn't have to be too tight. Also, because now we are securing it and then we are going to make it with a bit more of volume. So we'll just pull my hair a little. And then now it's time to shape this. There are so many ways of shaping it. Also, like, because I feel better like this, I loose a little bit the very beginning of the braid And then, as I did for the first one, I just try to see if I like it, how I like it. Well, there are so many ways, it's not always the same. Once I'm like, okay, this works, I will secure the very end of the braid with a pin. Now it looks a bit rectangular, not with a very good shape, but with the larger pins, I can easily fix it and give it a better shape. So for example, I would like it to be more rounded, kind of, and a bit smaller, let's say. So I just watch you see it in the mirror. I just see it in the mirror and try to give it a better shape. And I work hard for everything that I possess. All I wanted from her was her love and just a little tenderness. But whoa, my soul, she left me all alone and blue. So now looks already better, so we can move on. So we take the front part, the front section of hair, and now what I usually do, I take the upper part of hair. In my case, it's also like the longer hair. I take them and I try to do these easy victory rolls. And as you see, they're not so easy because I'm so bad on doing them. But just you take your hair, you put the two fingers, and you start to roll one into the other. I am really struggling, but with some practice, eventually, believe me, you can actually make it like this. I'm afraid you're gonna break it up. Break it in a thousand parts now. Then I'm securing the little roll up on my head in the front, just because I like it there, but you can put it wherever you want. But this is how I did for Rock That Swing performance. It takes only one pin to secure it on the bottom of the roll. Then I take the other section of hair, I twist it a little bit, and I try to understand how I like it. So in this case, I make it go around the roll. Do I like it? Yes, I like it. Okay, so now it's time to secure it, and of course it slipped. So we do it again. And now I'm securing it first on the side. And then I secure it in the front. Ooh, nice. Like this, I like it. It's not the very best, but it's not bad. So now we try to make it smoother, so I comb my hair on the back and I put some pins to make sure it's not like too thick, that part. Also with hairspray, I try to fix it a little bit. So thank you for being here with me, and I hope this was helpful. Of course, you can find your own ways and you can, you know, try and create something different. If you have some like idea to add or to adjust of this, let me know, because I want to. And also at the end, many times at the end, maybe because, you know, like especially in this part, there's some little hair like slipping away, to fix it without ruining everything, I just use one of these you know, little clips with a sparkle. I don't know, can you see? Okay. For example, I will just put one, for example, like this, but then like I usually put four or five, so it creates like a cool line, whatever. So thank you, and see you for the next dumb hair tutorial by Alexsia.